Hello friends, welcome to Inside Techs. This is the platform to learn about power transmission elements and its control system. So in today's video, we are going to learn about circuit breaker, some basic things about circuit breaker, and also some wiring part of the circuit breaker. Right, so circuit breaker is basically a switch. At our home, we have 230 volts at domestic system. So a switch can do the making and breaking of the circuit, whereas the voltage levels is in kilovolts for the substation. So for higher voltages, we have to use a larger switch which has some dielectric medium and which can be operated remotely from the control room. So some types of dielectric medium such as air, oil, vacuum or SF6 gas have to be used in the circuit breakers. It operates automatically when there is any fault in the equipment which the circuit breaker is protecting. So now the question may arise, why dielectric medium is required? So when the breaker operates to break the current, the arc is produced due to very high amount of current and high voltage levels. So this arc requires to be quenched as quickly as possible, so that it does not damage any further equipment, and this quenching of arc is done through this specific dielectric material. Now let's move on towards various types of circuit breaker. So basically circuit breakers can be classified based on their arc quenching medium. It can be air circuit breaker, it can be vacuum circuit breaker, oil circuit breaker, SF6 circuit breaker, and capacitor and resistance types of circuit breaker. The first one is the air circuit breaker. Air circuit breaker, as the name suggests, is using air as a compressed pressurized air to quench the arc. As you can see in the image, inside the tank there is very much compressed air, okay, that is used to quench the arc whenever there is any fault in the equipment. The next type is the vacuum circuit breaker. Vacuum circuit breakers uses vacuum as an arc quenching medium. So this type of vacuum circuit breakers are normally indoor circuit breakers used in the 11 kV panels. And also it can be used up to 33 kilovolts. Next category is the oil circuit breaker. Oil circuit breaker are basically, you can further classify them as bulk oil circuit breakers and minimum oil circuit breaker. Well, both type of circuit breakers are obsolete now. This kind of design is very, very rarely used in any substations because it contains a lot of oil as an arc quenching medium, and sometimes it becomes hazardous, right? So this type of breakers are not normally used in the practice today. The next category is SF6 circuit breaker. The very compact design and use of SF6 gas as an arc quenching medium. This has made this type of circuit breaker very, very useful in the current time situation, and normally at every substation SF6 gas circuit breakers are recently being used. So you can see in the image the SF6 circuit breaker. These are the poles. This is a compact mechanism, and inside these poles SF6 gas is filled. Last category is capacitor and resistance circuit breakers. SF6 gas circuit breakers are normally used for higher voltage levels from 33 kVs and above, and above 220 kilovolts, as the voltage increases, the arc will also be very huge. So it will require, apart from some arc quenching medium, it will require some kind of resistance that is provided in the interrupters so that the arc quenching becomes quickly and it takes less time to quench the arc, and further the damage is not done to any of the equipment. So as you can see over here, these are the contacts, and it also has an interrupter that contains of a resistance, so it will provide more resistive path to the arc, and so the arc is quenched quickly. This kind of breakers are normally used for 400 kV or 220 kV and above voltage levels. Now let us understand the basic construction of a circuit breaker. So as you can see over here, this is a minimum oiled circuit breaker, MOCB. This kind of design is obsolete now, but instead of oil, only SF6 gas is used as an arc quenching medium. So the basic structure remains quite similar. You can see over here there is a mechanism box, then there is connected, that is connected to the structure, and above this structure are the three poles, right? And inside this pole, the bottom porcelain part is covering the connecting rod. Then the top porcelain part is covering the interrupting chamber, right? And over here, because this is MOCB, so there is oil level indicator. But if it is a SF6 gas, then we do not have this oil level indicator. Instead, we have an indication gauge over here that will show how much SF6 gas is present inside the circuit breaker. So inside this pole, there will be a fixed contact and there will be a moving contact. So the fixed contact remains constant, it is fixed, and the moving contact helps the breaker to be open or close. So previously we have seen how the current flows into the CT, that is how 300 amperes gets converted into 1 ampere. Now this 1 ampere usually is connected with the control part of the circuit breaker, and how this mechanism works, let us now see that. So this is the general setup, how the CT is connected to a circuit breaker. In between there is a relay that sends command to the circuit breaker when should the circuit breaker trip in case of any fault is occurring on the equipment which this circuit breaker is protecting. So in normal conditions there will be a current flowing from the CT into the breaker, but whenever a fault will occur, let us see what happens when the fault occurs. So what happens when a fault occurs is, suppose whenever the fault is occurring, high amount of current will be flowing through this CT, which will result in a more amount of current in its secondary terminals, due to which what will happen, this relay will be energized, the circuit will be closed, and the trip command will be given to the circuit breaker. See, due to the current flowing, the relay will be operating and the trip command is sent to the circuit breaker, so the breaker gets tripped. Now let us understand some basic wiring of the circuit breaker. We will continue this breaker wiring in detail in the next videos, but for now let us just understand few parts, that is remote close and trip, how TNC switches. Then there is a remote trip circuit 1 over here, then a remote trip circuit 2 is over here. This is a simple wiring of a circuit breaker. In details we will see in the upcoming videos. In the next video we will continue with the wiring of breaker to panel. So guys, keep watching and let us know if you have any doubts from the breaker part or in any other topic, please write in the comment section. Thank you.